Welcome to Holden Evening Prayer this evening, April 1st at St. Matthew's Lutheran Church. We're glad to have all of you with us tonight. If you need the bulletin for tonight's service and would like to follow along, you can find that on our website at stmatthews.us. And hopefully you've subscribed to our YouTube channel so you can get all of our worship services and notifications for them as they're coming up. We're glad to have you with us, and please follow along. Jesus Christ, you are the light of the world. The light no darkness can overcome. Stay with us now, for it is evening, and the day is almost over. Let your light scatter the darkness, and shine within your people here. Shine on every land and brave. our prayers come before you, O God, as incense. And may your presence surround and fill us, so that in union with all creation we might sing your praise and your love in our lives.
Amen.
You might remember from the past few weeks that we've been using the Lenten devotions provided by ELCA World Hunger. We invite you to make donations to ELCA World Hunger as we are using their resources, but also they are doing some awesome things in the world. We also here at St. Matthew's have been giving a lot of our Lenten, midweek Lenten offerings to Lutheran Disaster Response. So if you want to give online to them, I'm sure they would greatly appreciate it right now, as I'm sure they will have a part in what is going on in our world right now. But this is what I'm about to read is an excerpt from the Lenten devotion from ELCA World Hunger offered this year. Our reading comes from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 37. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Now, if you are a farmer, or if you grew up on a farm, or even if you are a passionate gardener, you are probably very, very familiar with the intimate relationship between humans and the rest of God's creation. Dependent on soil, water, sunlight, and more, farming reminds us of both God's abundant provision and the interconnections between humans and the rest of creation. Scripture, too, reminds us of these connections. As the ancient Hebrews journey from Egypt, they do so in hopes of a fertile land from which they will be able to draw sustenance. In many of the parables of Jesus, creation serves as an illustration for God and God's coming reign. Despite how far we have come in knowledge and technological advancement, this fact remains true, that we will not survive without the rest of creation. All of creation rises and falls together. For some, that truth is lived out every day. For others, it may be easier to forget about our dependence on the creation that God has provided and the responsible stewardship of it to which we are called. As we journey in hope toward Easter, we are reminded in Holy Scripture of God's promise that salvation is not for humans alone, but for all of creation, which groans. It groans until God's reign shall come in fullness. This hope that we have is an active hope, and we know that God has called us to work now, tending to both human communities and all of creation. So even as we continue to live through a time where our hearts, our minds, our bodies, and our souls groan for new life, God is at work. In, through, and among us, and all of creation, breathing new life even when we think all is lost. And right now, maybe nature, creation, is one place we can turn to for a bit of a boost. Sitting on your porch, watching the rainfall, sitting in the fresh grass starting to green up again in these coming spring months, taking a few minutes to garden, literally stopping to smell the flowers. In doing so, we are reminded of our interconnectedness. The interconnectedness of all life. Maybe nature is a place where we can receive the breath of God for our dry, dry bones. So in light of this, I have a few questions for reflection for you. In light of this, in what ways does the church or our community foster appreciation for the abundance of God's creation? Feel free to write a few notes on the YouTube page if you would like, in the YouTube chat, or just think about that for a few minutes. along with that, what do you think are some steps your church, your community, or even your family can take to care for creation? And finally, where in your community do you find God breathing new life into dry bones? Please pray with me. Dear God, we give you thanks. Thanks for your promise to breathe new life into our dry bones, our bones that are seeking community, our bones that are seeking connection, our bones that are seeking your love. Give us strength, especially during this time of separation, where we might be secluded into our homes. Help us to find ways to help breathe new life into the world around us, even amidst all of the changes that are happening. Give us your strength, your hope, your peace, and your breath. In your Son's name we pray. Amen. We continue tonight's service with the Annunciation. And then that will be followed by the Magnificat, in which we invite you to join to sing along. An angel went from God to a town called Nazareth to a woman whose name was Mary. The angel said to her, "Rejoice, O highly with you. You shall bear Great and merciful God, source and ground of all goodness and life, give to your people the peace that passes all understanding and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
God, remember us in your love and teach us to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Let us bless our God.
Praise and thanks to you.
May God, Creator, bless us and keep us. May Christ be ever the light of our lives. May the Spirit above be our guide and friend for all of our Thank you for joining us this week. Please be on the lookout for more information regarding Holy Week services. We will be offering some of those online and sending some things home with our families. If you would like those resources sent to you and are not on our mailing list, please email us at stmatthews@stmatthews.us. Go in peace. The peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.